happy Busch Gardens morning, all you junkies out there.
Hello.
Hey.
Nice of you to join me today.
Yeah.
So, it's Friday the 20th, 1 week after we did our Hollow Scream episode. I hope you guys watched that. That was some fun.
Yep.
As far as what we're doing today, we have no clue. We're just gonna go ahead and hop into the park and do our normal stuff. Probably give you some updates on, Jungala area, which is now gonna be known as Wild Oasis.
Ooh.
And we'll see if Scorpion is still standing but not operational. And on any other things that we might be doing. So, just stay tuned. Don't skip through any of this video because I'm sure you're gonna enjoy it all. Check-in and security was a breeze to come in. And now we're heading to guest relations for our wrap sheet and our other amazing prizes today. I just heard some checks. They said main break check and transfer check on Aaron Wazzy. That means they ran the test run and they're almost ready to open, guys. Yeah, there goes another empty train. D.H. Bagham Circus of Fear. One of the better Hollow Scream houses around. I definitely enjoyed it this year. And as you can tell, the park looks kind of empty today, which is kind of nice. We just got in a couple of runs on Iron Gwazi. And after riding a gator, now let's check out some gators. Where are the gators? Here's the gators. Oh, there's two of them. There's another one back there. And that's all I can see for now. On to more rides. Even with a notice and on the website saying that the Sky Ride was going to be closed till November 3rd, as you can see, the Sky Ride is open. Now, what we've noticed today is Falcon's Fury has been sitting up there for all morning long. Not sure what's going on with that. But while we're up here, we can at least give you a good bird's eye view of some of the happenings that are happening around here. There goes Cheetah Hunt. As Cheetah Hunt passes by, we're kind of coming up to Serengeti Flyer. And folks, I have some bad news for you.
It's still down.
It's still down. And from what I'm hearing, the Serengeti Flyer will be down until spring of 2025, from what I heard. And here is Phoenix Rising. As you can see, they did a whole bunch of good landscaping work right here in this area. And they got the net up there. And every time I go by that net, I feel like I'm gonna hit it with my feet. Looks like it already caught something up there. What is that that it caught? Huh. Yeah, it caught something. And good thing it caught it and not the train or anything else. Now, when we get over to this area, I'll show you this area right here. But I have noted that the small rides that were over there, the Busch flyers, the train, the kiddie train ride, and the motorcycles, I took that piece of land from Google Earth and placed it over there by the Ubanga Banga bumper cars. And guess what, guys? All three of those rides fit perfectly in that spot. I didn't see any tigers, but we do have this scare zone, Ragnar's Revenge. Nice Nordic themed, Viking themed. But yeah, in this area right over here, right next to the Ubanga Banga bumper cars, where the remote controlled trucks and boats were, there's still a nice bit of land right there that if they cleared it out, they could put a few of the kiddie rides there. And I have a feeling that they might be doing that along with the update to Jungala for Wild Oasis. I keep on wanting to say Wild Surge. But yeah, Wild Surge is a junior drop tower that was over there. That during a maintenance cycle, I think it caught on fire. Not exactly 100% sure about all the details on that, but it did catch on fire and it has been SBNO for quite some time. Just saw an empty train on Kumba go by, which means they're running a test run and it's 11 o'clock, so it's about time they, I think, opened up Kumba. So far, every time we pass by the Phoenix Rising, we never caught a train as it's flying by us here. We still have yet to catch a train going by as we're going by. Let's see if we see another little rhino out there. We might have to take the train to go see the new baby rhino. I didn't see anything out there. Let's see if we see anything out this way. No, I don't see any boulders out there. Yeah, that would be a shame if they're still stuck up there and there's actually people on there stuck up there. But I don't think people are actually on there riding it. I think just the mechanics are up there, or maybe they're just hanging it up there for, I don't know. I have no idea why they would keep it up there like that. Unless somebody is working up there in the top, in the tower. You would think that they would want to keep it down lower to the ground and work up there. Aww. Check out all the Nyalas here. And we're going to go ahead and continue having a wonderful fun day here at Busch Gardens right after we capture the Thompson Gazelles. All in the shade over there. Heading into the edge of Africa, and I notice Falcon's Fury is no longer at the top of the tower. Let's see how close we can get to some of these giraffes. We got some crazy looking birds over here. Looks like we got some ducks over here. And some other birds. So here we have at the edge of Africa, we can go see the hippos, or we can go this way to see the lions and hyenas and the giraffes. But I don't see no giraffes over here at this side of the park. Oh, way out there. They're way out there. It's the hyenas. One of them sleeping right here. Oh, there she is, way back there. Hi, Rose. So if you notice, they have walls all the way up here, leading all the way back to first aid, covering scorpion. Oh, no problem. Have work walls over here too. Lockers are still available for use, it looks like. And if you look in there, we still have the train in the station. So yes, folks, Scorpion is standing but not operational. She still stands. Just rode Kumba, and I notice out there by the retention ponds, I don't think we can see it from here. No, I can't see it from here, but just over there, there's a big pile of dirt and a couple of what looks like either generators or pumps or something. But yep, they definitely have something going on out there by the retention ponds. Seeing if there's anything interesting around here, which I do not see. Nope, not seeing anything special. I do see that there's no water here in Congo. Yeah, the Congo looks bone dry. And Congo is closed for today. But yeah, it's totally empty, no water. Not sure if I would consider that a marker, but it's definitely orange in color, just like over there. There's another one all along with a Looks like a chip of paint. Hunking down the railroad tracks. Don't see anything special going on over here. Nope, no new markers or anything that we can see. Everything looks normal still back here. It just came off the you bang your bang your bumper cars and she collided with me too many times. Almost made me flip over, but of course they are pretty much well done that they can't flip over. So this is the area here. It does go back a little bit further back behind those trees, but this area right here is part of Jungala, and it is a good spot, and I have a feeling that they are really thinking about putting the Busch flyers and the train and possibly the motorcycles back in this area. I was just actually on Kumba, and where they were storing the Busch flyers back in the Kumba parking lot, back in the treetop parking lot, or Rhino parking lot, whatever parking lot they want to call it these days. I'm still going to call it the treetop parking lot. But the Busch flyers was no longer in the parking lot, so they moved it. Who knows what they're going to do with it. Now, could they put it over here in Wild Oasis? So right here is planned to have Wild Oasis here coming in spring of 2025 with a renovated Wild Surge, all new area back here. Let's see if they got any work going on over here. I do see trucks back here. And I do hear work. Sounds like I hear work. Well, look at that. That has been all cleared out. Looks like there's guys up there taking measurements of something. I see somebody out with a ruler. So that is so far the project on Wild Oasis. It's gonna have multi-animal habitats, climb on the ropes. Hopefully they fix up a Wild Surge that's in here. I do hear them working back there. Unfortunately, we can't go back there. But there's definitely people working on the treetop trails. There's some workers up there. Yep, they're all over the place over there. trying to figure out what they're doing up there. Probably trying to make sure that the trails are safe, the rope bridges are safe, and everything else. Yep. Oh, we are leaving Jungala now. Didn't see any orangutans. They're not up. And doesn't look like they're by the doorway either. No. Doesn't look like the orangutans are out today. And didn't see them up top, didn't see them on the ground. Right here, right across from the sky ride and the log flume. Back here behind Tigris. There's a bit of a plot of land here. And this is actually a place, there's actually a gate right there. Right there's a gate. And I was thinking this area here could be possibly opened up for a station for a Giga. They could put the Giga station right here, and the Giga can go out that way, can go out that way, can go just about any way it wants to go. Build that Giga, build that Giga, build that Giga.
Now over to the right hand side, we do have all these colorful walls and buildings which are a part of the Pantopia area. In Pantopia, you'll find Dragonfire Grill, which is one of our three main dining establishments. Falcon's Fury is a drop tower, folks. It'll take you up over 300 feet into the air, make you face the ground, and then drop you all the way back down freefall style at about 65 miles per hour. As we pass the mighty Phoenix Rising, we are entering the Serengeti with all of our animals, so please keep all hands, feet, and other appendages inside the train at all times, and remember to always remain seated. Por favor, manténgase sentados. Now folks, there is one more ride I'd like to mention off to the right, and it's that giant purple tower known as the Serengeti Flyer. The Serengeti Flyer is North America's largest dueling swing ride. It'll swing you back and forth at about 68 miles per hour and take you up to a maximum height of 135 feet. Now let's see if we can't find some animals out there to the left-hand side. Well, looks like we're starting off with a bunch of rocks out there. We gotta talk about them from time to time because, you know, we always take them for granted here at Busch Gardens. Oh, that one was bad. It's okay, the jokes will get bolder as we go. Looks like we do have some zebra out there to the left. Those are the Grant zebra, one of the smallest of all known zebra species. In fact, they are so short you can tell they're not related to the horse. They're actually related to the donkey. Now, contrary to popular belief, the zebra is not black and white. It is, in fact, base white with brown striping. But the stripes do go all the way around their bodies and connect on either side. The zebra species is actually very accommodating in that it will travel at the speed of its slowest member, no matter how large the herd is. Once again, those are the Grant zebra to the left. Also on the left-hand side, folks, you're going to see a rhino out there on that little island. That is a black rhino. Her name is Jody. And the reason she's on an island by herself is because the black rhino is incredibly territorial, meaning they like to be by themselves at all times. They're also about half the size of the white rhinos we have here at Busch, only weighing about 3,000 pounds.
There's Jody. Been a long time since we've seen Jody.
Yeah, it's a bit dry heat today. She likes that a lot better than when it's muggy outside.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Also on the left-hand side, those white animals with the curled antlers, those are known as the Adax antelope. The Adax antelope have this really cool trick. They can change colors with the weather. So when it's hot outside, they're entirely white. But when it's cold outside, they start turning dark brown to retain their body heat.
Goodbye, Station Master!
Here we go. All right, folks. We are now on our way to the Stanleyville train station.
This is interesting. So Thompson's gazelle was literally born 30 minutes ago. And then the crown cranes are nesting right now. So they got an egg over there.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so we have babies everywhere.
But there was a gazelle that was just born?
Yeah, he's right there. You see him poke his head up right there in the flowers?
Oh, wow.
Itty bitty, like the size of a rabbit.
Wow.
Starting to the left-hand side, we have the green and yellow coaster known as Cheetah Hunt. Cheetah Hunt is a magnetic launch coaster that'll launch you three different times along your journey and take you up to speeds of 0 to 60 or 0 to Cheetah in a matter of seconds. Blue and yellow coaster known as Montu. Montu is named after the Egyptian god of war, and rightfully so. It'll take you up over 149 feet into the air and drop you down screaming at about 60 to 65 miles per hour. It is also known as one of the top 10 inverted roller coasters in the entire United States. Once again, inverted means that the track itself is upside down, so you won't be sitting on top, you'll be dangling feet first beneath it. But this ride will put you upside down 7 different times. And as we pass the mighty Montu, we are now heading into the animal area, so please keep all hands, feet, and other appendages inside the train at all times. And remember to always remain seated. Por favor, manténgase sentados. Out to the left-hand side, amongst the palm trees, you may notice some very tall, long-necked creatures. Those are known as the reticulated giraffe. The reticulated giraffe can stand up to 19 feet tall when fully grown, and they do practically everything in the standing position. This includes eating, drinking, sleeping, and of course, giving birth, which means a baby giraffe's first view of the world is a 6-foot free fall straight to the ground head first. They're also one of the only animal species able to see in full color, like we humans do, and are easily identifiable by the reticulated pattern along their bodies. Once again, those are the reticulated giraffe on the left. Also on the left-hand side, more towards the front of the train, we see some gray animals out there with shaggy white beards. Those are known as the wildebeest, also called the white-bearded gnu in some parts of the world. Wildebeest have been known to travel in herds of up to 1 million strong in something called the Great Migration. This can actually kick up a dust cloud so large it can be seen from the International Space Station. If you didn't know, there's only 2 known species of wildebeest out in the wild. The first one is the blue wildebeest, which is what we're seeing on the left-hand side. The other one is the black wildebeest, which is a solitary animal and is incredibly endangered. The white rhino is the third largest land mammal on the planet, weighing up to 6,000 pounds. Even at that weight, they can still run about 36 miles per hour. And when they're in a group, they're not known as a herd, they're actually known as a crash of rhino. Also, folks, their horns are not made of bone or connected to their skull. They're actually made of a substance called keratin. Now, if you don't know what keratin is, it's basically the same stuff as your fingernails and your hair. So really, if you want to think about it this way, the rhino's horn is like one large nose hair.
Yeah, thought so.
Also on the right-hand side, but thankfully we stopped because I can actually talk about all the animals. We have the brown animals out there with the large curved horns known as the sable antelope. The sable antelope have a matriarchal society, which means that the dominant female typically runs the entire herd. And they actually have this really cool natural defense mechanism in that they can sit in a perfect circle, facing all directions to protect themselves from predators. Also, because their horns are long and thin, they do not charge forward to protect themselves. They actually have to throw their head backward or to the side. Now, please remain seated, folks. That is Fiazzi and our dominant female rhino.
Our little potato spud is no longer a potato spud.
No, he's big.
He big.
Big as mom is.
Yeah. Oh, well, about the half size as mom.
Once again, folks, those were our white rhino on the left.
Hi, Biazzi. Oh, wow.
And coming up on the right-hand side, we have some shaggy brown creatures up there. Those are known as the Dufasa waterbuck. The Dufasa waterbuck, contrary to their name, are not aquatic creatures. However, they will run to water if they feel threatened by a predator and do secrete a special oil to make them water resistant.
All right, folks, we are coming up behind the Jangala area for the new wild oasis area planned for 2025. We took a look at the front side of it, nothing but work walls, but now we can check it out from the back right over here. Well, not right here, but soon.
Now, folks, off to the left-hand side, we do have our Jangala area, which is home to our tigers and orangutans, but of course, our very own Chick-fil-A as well. Now, you may have known the Jangala area for all the climbing towers, and actually, they're going ahead and refurbishing all those climbing towers for the future. It will be renamed, and I'm not allowed to say what it is just yet, but keep in touch, folks. We will let you know once they're ready to display it.
You already know.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was an announcement. There was an announcement. Here's Air Grover. And no, they don't have the, they don't have a beeper yet. Sorry, no beeper. Thank you very much. I'm sure he'll be very happy. Well, sad to know that it's not working yet, but happy to have get it. I know it's not your fault. Thank you. Yeah. Looks like the pink chickens are enjoying the weather. And with our pink chickens in our background, we're all gonna have to say we had a wonderful day here.
Mm-hmm.
Got you some updates. I wish I could have gotten you an update behind the scenes of Wild Oasis, Jangala area. But unfortunately, the camera got too hot and shut off all by itself. So we're gonna have to try it again another time. But we did get you some good front views of it. So, until the next time, we'll catch you at the parks.